watch some wrestling.
One hell of a coward. So Mayhem, best 2 out of 3 fall. Nowhere to run, nowhere to hide. You better get ready, because I am.
I don't really know what you're getting at. It sounds kind of like challenging you or something.
Is that
right?
Take them out. Take them out.
I mean, honestly, I'll be honest, I've known you guys for a pretty long time. And I'm only seeing you know what your problem is with me.
You know what the problem is. You know what the day we've got here, this moment's coming. You know it.
I'm going to ask you right now.
Okay.
Next month, May 25th, a match or not? What's your answer?
No way.
I think you might want to say yes to that.
Guitar. You try to get me in the ring, you've been trying to get your hands on me, but it ain't gonna happen. And on May 25th, the rock star Chris Cole's gonna get his revenge. We're gonna embarrass you in the ring in front of all your fans.
Rock star Chris Cole, on May 25th at IHW's Mayhem, you finally get your big opportunity. You get your big chance, one-on-one with Ryan Storm. What you've been begging for. Well, I'll tell you something, Chris. If you think that what I did to that little guitar of yours is bad, you haven't seen anything yet.
And let's be honest, if I can't beat Chris Cole, I don't think I belong here. And as for you, Kevin Tyler, I don't really know what you've been talking about. All your yelling and screaming and nonsensical rambling about something in the past. But I'll tell you one thing, you're starting to get on my nerves. And when I get my hands on you, and I will get my hands on you, I'm gonna shut you up.
BT Bobby, man, you think you're tough just because you won some little match at April Rain? I got bad news for you, little I let you win that match. Now, May 25th, no holds bars, I get to beat the crap out of your ugly little face with any kind of blood instrument I want for as long as I want. There's gonna be no count outs. There isn't gonna be a 3 count. It's just gonna be me beating you bloody until the ref calls the bell.
I think that the fans feel like I do, and they're actually kind of looking forward to seeing Sidewinder get his ass kicked by BT in a street fight. As we all know, if there's anybody that you're gonna, you know, put money on in a street fight, if you're stupid enough to gamble on wrestling, it's BT Bobby Man. So expect some, you know, cans flying, some chairs flying, some kendo sticks come May 25th, because BT is going to bring the hardware and Sidewinder is probably going to feel something.
Mr. Suave, the clock is ticking and time is running out. Every day that passes, we're getting that much closer to mayhem. And on May 25th, history is gonna go down in the making, because if you walk out victorious that night, you will be the longest reigning IHW champion there ever was. But when I walk out of that match victorious, I will be the only man to hold that title twice. It will be the beginning of a new Titus era.
Roy Storm, we wanted this match, we wanted to beat you and embarrass you in front of all your fans. The fans that you've been crediting with your success from the beginning. Thank the fans. Did you forget where you came from? Did you forget about Pettipaw? Did you forget about Rage? Most importantly, did you forget about me and everything I've done for your career? Ryan Storm, I started your career, and tonight we begin the end of it. So without further ado, remember you! You wanted the best! You got the best!
Performance by Iron Giant, just a sign of things to come. What a great show we've got in store for you. It's Mayhem 08, starting things off with the rock star Chris Cole versus Ryan Storm, and a hard shot by Ryan Storm to kick things off.
I don't think Chris Cole went down. I don't think Chris Cole's quite grasped what he's got himself into. He's taking on a former IHW champion and a former AWA North Atlantic tag champion.
That is Johnny Chase joining myself, Daryl Kwan, the new voice of Innovative Hybrid Wrestling, here for Mayhem 08. There you see in the ring Ryan Storm and the rock star Chris Cole. Ryan Storm wearing the white trunks, Chris Cole wearing the very feminine rainbow tights, and that is Ryan Storm with a hard tie up there of the rock star Chris Cole. As you mentioned, Cole is tough here tonight, and what a hard backhand by Ryan Storm. Controlling things here in the early going, and Chase, is that something we can expect to see throughout the entire match?
Oh, no doubt about it. Well, looks like Cole got the control back there, but looked too smooth as there's being heel kick. Ryan Storm has got years more experience than the Rockstar Chris Cole. The Rockstar Chris Cole claims to be a rock star, but I have yet to see a music video, a single, a CD. Hell, he doesn't even have anything on iTunes.
I think I'm almost deaf from listening to the Rockstar Chris Cole's jam sessions in the past, breaking my eardrums. Not exactly a rock star in my opinion. As there you see a back body drop by Storm, a quick count and a two count by the referee. Storm thought he might have had a quick pin there to kick things off. Some hard shots now by Storm with Cole just hanging onto the ropes. There you see is his manager, I guess you could call him his manager, Kevin Tyler, ringside. Kevin Tyler could play a part in this match. He's been known to get involved, and he's not looking too happy with what he's seeing so far. And there you see him right now getting involved, pulling Chris Cole out of the ring.
Ref's got to keep his eyes on Kevin Tyler. You know, he may be like a little fart that runs around with Chris Cole, but he's got a wealth of knowledge. And Kiss, as you said, there's been past issues with Ryan Storm and Kevin Tyler. Not going to get into them in this broadcast, but he made his feelings very clear in the ring.
And I don't know what it is with these two and their hugging, but it seems like they embrace each other more than they ever wrestle. And now you see Ryan Storm going to the outside.
Chris Cole turned his back for 1 second.
Oh, what a chop by Ryan Storm. That is going to leave a mark.
Oh, Kevin Tyler trying to get involved there. And
grabbing the hair of Ryan Storm. Some very girly tactics. Yeah. And now, will Ryan Storm finally get his hands on Kevin Tyler? Chase, the referee continuing to count here. We've got to note there is only 10 seconds for them to get back into the ring.
That's right, there is a 10 count. Storm got ready to get himself back into the ring. And
Kevin Tyler throwing some powder in the face of Storm, hauling him down off the apron as Storm wants to get back into the ring.
Nope,
referee continuing to count. He's up to 8. Chris Cole gets back into the ring. No! It can't end like this. Where's Ryan Storm?
No, come on. Oh.
And the Rockstar, Chris Cole, gets the victory.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of this match, as a result of a countout, Rockstar Chris Cole.
And the Rockstar, Chris Cole, gets the victory over Ryan Storm via countout. Oh man, can you believe that?
That's pretty much a glorified handicap match with Kyler Bader. Oh, jeez.
Storm getting back in, not impressed with what just took place.
Neither are the fans. If you hear that chant, I'm not going to repeat it over the mic, but fans displeased with what just happened.
And folks, what a show we have in store for you tonight. Of course, you just saw the Rockstar Chris Cole picking up the victory to start things off. We've also got a best 2 out of 3 falls match, Ken Banks versus Julian Young. We will finally determine which of the two is the better man. We've also got a street fight, BT Bobby Mann versus Sidewinder, and Team America taking on Marco Estrada and Pee Wee.
Well, let's hope so. So I basically did this for all fine folks here to review.
Yeah!
folks, what a match we have here for our second match. Two titles on the line, not one, but two. The North Atlantic World Association Tag Team titles and the vacant AWA World Tag Team Championship. Both titles coming from the States. And we have, of course, the Team America in the ring who want to take those titles back home with them. Marco Estrada and Pee Wee. And some lovely young lady who's about to take Marco's pants off. Boy, I wish I could be Marco right now.
As do I. This is a little trick.
Baby! There it is, Marco Estrada, folks! Now back to the match, of course. Two titles on the line. Boy, what would this mean for IHW to bring those two titles back here? To keep them here, I guess.
Well, it'll be very important. Actually, for a little factoid, the North Atlantic Wrestling Association Tag Team titles were the former name of the AWA North Atlantic Tag titles. Titles that Sonny and Larry, Team America, brought up their debut match in IHW, probably losing those to Julian Young and Titus some time ago. This would mean a great thing because Marco and Pee-wee are not tag specialists.
I was just going to say that. Marco and Pee-wee are in tough here. They're not used to fighting in tag team matches.
No, they're used as singles careers. They wrestle really frequently in Quebec. But they're both high-flying. They both take very high risks. And that might spell danger if they are up against the big, tough team known as Team America. Like I said in the opening announcements, combined weight, 686 pounds. And they've got the tools to get the job done. They are multiple-time tag team champions in several different organizations. I would like to name them all, but this is only a three-hour show.
And you see Marco there standing in the corner after that hard shot to open the things up here and still slow limping around in there trying to get the feeling back. And I'm sure every body part after that. And again, just slammed to the mat by Sonny Roselli. Look at the size difference. Sonny is a solid piece of meat.
Yeah, Marco's not going to win a strength game. His game has got to hit him hard, hit him fast. You know, take to the air, hit some of those high-flying moves, maybe able to knock the big man off his feet.
Now Marco's smart, just backing up into the corner there, taking his time, trying to get some sort of strategy. And there you see going to his knee to get under the arms of Sonny Roselli, but the big ass of Roselli just knocking Estrada back, and of course Sonny back in control now, as you can see, with a wrist high up.
It's not Marco going for a waist lock there, but Sonny's waist a little bit too big to get that.
And there you see some, I don't want to say flexibility, but some nice nip-ups there from Estrada. That was about five in a row. Both these guys have a bit of a cocky attitude, so it's a bit of clash of egos in there right now. Flexing the biceps. I think Marco has the bigger biceps, but Roselli has the... Oh, boy. Folks, you might want to close your eyes and put your sunglasses on. If I was Marco Estrada and I was just going to take advantage of that... Oh, baby, what an enziguri!
Don't go too far off that corner, Marco. You're going to get hit by Larry.
Looks like he just took the head off Roselli.
And in comes Pee-wee.
First tag of the match as Pee-wee comes in and going for a diving cross body, but just caught by the bigger Roselli. Pee-wee landing on his feet, however. Missed clothesline there by Pee-wee and takes a big boot to the gut, and now a big fist to the back. Everything's big on Roselli. Another wrist tie.
What's that saying? Everything's bigger in Texas?
I thought they were from Maine or Massachusetts, but either way.
Well, everything's big.
Down in the States, that's right.
Forearm shot there, and Pee-wee's got to get back into this match somehow.
Oh, what a move by Pee-wee, just flipping over the bigger Roselli. Oh, Roselli going for a big backdrop, I guess, and taking some boots to the face there from Estrada off the top rope, as these two guys are going airborne here on Roselli.
Like I said, that high-flying style is what's going to win them this matchup.
Hard knee by Estrada there allows Pee-wee for a quick pin. Counted two by the referee. Another tag by the team of Estrada and Pee-wee. They're keeping each other fresh here in the early going. Some quick tags. Estrada back in the match now with Roselli.
Oh. I don't think that headbutt worked out too well for Estrada as he slips over.
Now a hard shot to the back of the head of Roselli by Estrada, now kicking the shins of Roselli, and Roselli just hopping around him. Now you see that dancing that Larry Hunter and Donnie Dangerous did not want to see in the early going. Team USA has to regroup here. Larry Hunter trying to regroup his team in the corner. Roselli going to take a break. They're both heading out of the ring now.
The crowd's chanting for him to dance it. After that workout in the ring, I don't think so.
But watch this. Pee-wee and Estrada both going to the top. Going airborne! Oh, how about that? Diving cross bodies off the top rope by Pee-wee and Estrada, and all four men are down. And there you see Pee-wee getting involved in the crowd. They love him here, don't they?
All those, absolutely. I said it before, I said it again. Pee-wee's been a fan favorite since day one here in IHW. He's always got the fans to support. Oh, up
going
top.
For the BME, and he's gonna miss it. What Pee-wee calls the perfect moonsault was picture perfect, except he hit nothing but Matt. What a shot by Larry Hunter. You could hear that shot for that chop all the way in downtown Moncton.
This is Larry's first opportunity in the ring as he just drilled Pee-wee with that clothesline. Pee-wee calls himself the man of a million smiles, but he ain't doing too much smiling right now.
Team America back in control here.
He's definitely got to get that tag. Larry is the fresher man right now, and Pee-wee's definitely got to get out there and get Estrada in.
Hard scoop slam by Hunter. Looking to keep Pee-wee on the mat. Hard elbow drop off the ropes. And Pee-wee just writhing around in pain. Quick pin here by Team America, two count.
Pee-wee's got to watch himself on those covers. Like, not only one, like I said, two tag team championships are on the line. The vacant AWA World Tag Team Championship. Now, not just like the North Atlantic, that's a region. AWA is the world. That means that you are one of the best tag teams in the world.
Marco Estrada coming in to create some interference, but that allows a two-on-one here for Team America. You can see the hand slap there by Sonny Roselli. No tag actually made, but the referee didn't see it and doesn't kick Roselli out of the match.
Oh, classic move by any tag team.
Oh, and what a boot by Sonny Roselli! How can he get up that high?
Sonny's been known for that lariat. Oh, Marco able to break up the count. For a big man, I'm surprised that Sonny is able to do that type of leg lariat.
I still can't believe I saw him go that high in the air. Looking for a double suplex on Pee-wee, and that's going to leave a mark as Pee-wee slammed into the mat there by the double suplex of this much bigger Team America.
Team America using the top rope to their advantage, using it to springboard into a much faster, a much more crisp double suplex.
Pee-wee taking much of the heat here so far in the early going, just being slammed all over the place here by Team America. He's got to get Marco Estrada a tag and get Estrada into the match.
I think I asked yourself one question now. Sonny and Larry, Team America, they're the more seasoned veterans, if you will, here in IHW. Pee-wee and Marco are still very young in this game called pro wrestling. What would it mean for someone like Marco and Pee-wee to become an AWA World Tag Team Champions?
And those chops, look at the chest of Pee-wee, it's just turning red. Now Pee-wee fighting back with some chops of his own. Backs Larry Hunter all the way back into the corner, go for a springboard splash. Right into the turnbuckle as Hunter able to get out of the way.
Now Pee-wee just got sandwiched there.
Between the turnbuckle and Larry Hunter. Now the inexperience in tag matches here for Pee-wee and Marco Estrada is proven to be a little bit evident here so far as Pee-wee is not able to get Estrada into the match.
No, exactly. Pee-wee's got to hit a big impact move, knock Larry off his feet for at least a few seconds so he can crawl over and get Estrada into this matchup.
And now you see Pee-wee gaining some momentum here from the fans, some elbows to Hunter, but Hunter just sticks the knee out and jams it right into the gut of Pee-wee. As that smiley face on the seat of his pants is not going to be smiling much longer if it keeps getting slammed into the mat like it has so far. Another tag here from Team America.
I just wish Sonny would just pull that singlet back up. That's just really disgusting.
I think the fans and a double big splash.
Oh,
Marco Estrada coming in and saving his teammate there, because I think that would have been over if Sonny Roselli was able to get a pin.
He's definitely had enough, but here's the thing. They are both covering him. The ref can't count for a three if both men are in the ring for the cover. Has to be the legal manage. What a slam there by Sonny. Is he going in for the cover?
Quick cover there, two count by the referee. And again, I thought that was over as Pee-wee just driven into the mat again by one of the Team America members.
You see Pee-wee actually caught the bottom rope there, forcing the break. Pee-wee trying to come back now.
Some hard shots to the gut of Sonny Roselli, now the legal man in the match.
Uh-oh.
And what's he doing now? He's got Pee-wee on the shoulders, going for tornado slam. What a slam by Sonny Roselli. It is over. One, two. And Pee-wee able to get the shoulder up with some help from his teammate, Marco Estrada. Jace, I thought it was over there.
I thought it was over too. That tornado slam there by Sonny Roselli, all power. Now Larry Hunter back in.
Hunter is just focused. Look at the face of that man. His eyes have not left Pee-wee since the match began.
Well, they don't call him the enforcer for nothing.
And of course, we got to keep an eye on Dangerous Donnie down there wearing the green tights, as he could have a part to play as the third man here. So far, hasn't, but no, just cheering on his two teammates.
Pretty much been a backup enforcer for Team America last month. Larry Hunter, unable to make an IHW event due to an injury, but he's fresh and he's ready to win those tag team titles.
And you can tell, the focus level is just so much higher for Larry Hunter. He was worried a little bit about the focus level of his teammate Sonny Roselli at the beginning. Roselli wanted to give the fans what they wanted and have the two big men dance.
Oh.
Hard clothesline there by Pee-wee, but not able to knock down. And now a dropkick, and finally, one of the Team America members are knocked down to the mat.
Pee-wee's got to
get
that
tag.
Now.
He doesn't know where Marco is. He's trying to get over there.
Larry's got him by the boot. He's not going to let him get that tag.
And that's the wily veteranness of Team America, as they do get the tag. And Roselli, the legal man once again, just a boot to the back of the head of Pee-wee. And Pee-wee, again, taking a lot of damage here.
Team America very good at isolating their opponent, not letting them even get close to Marco Estrada.
And this match is starting to get on as well. Fairly long match for these two guys who aren't used to tag team matches. As you mentioned, they're singles guys. A bulldog here for Roselli, just driving the face of Pee-wee into the mat once again. And now you see Estrada trying to spray off his teammate, going for the pin. And Pee-wee, with some help in the water, perhaps waking him up a little bit, able to kick out there. Now Estrada taking a drink on the apron.
I think he's thinking Pee-wee a little bit dehydrated from all the punishment he's taken. Spraying him a little bit of water will cool him down.
Another tag here by Team America, as these guys are making their shifts short, if you want to look at a hockey analogy, and keeping each other fresh.
Yeah, no doubt about it. For these two guys, they're bigger guys. They have to keep the fresh tags in. You know,
there on Pee-wee.
You know, I don't know their workout regime, but it can't involve any type of dieting.
I think their workout regime is driving their station wagon from Maine to a McDonald's.
Yeah, Larry Hunter going for multiple covers, but Pee-wee just will not stay down for three.
And that has got to use up some of Pee-wee's energy, whatever little energy he has left.
No doubt about it. Marco's just so close, he could just easily get in, hit some type of move, and be done with it. I think he's just worried that the ref is going to disqualify him for being in the ring.
And with two titles on the line, a disqualification is the last thing that these guys need. Hunter, still the legal man in the match, now picking Pee-wee up. Pee-wee almost unable to stand on his own. Another tag here by Team America, once again with a short shift, as now Roselli the legal man. And Pee-wee can't have much left. He's taking a lot of damage, but there's a boot to the face of Roselli. Now he's got him. What are we going to see here? He's got both their heads.
Oh!
No! What a move by Pee-wee! That was like a mix of a neck breaker and I don't even know. That was awesome. Two
it's
moves
hit Larry
the same
with
time.
A DDT and Sonny with a net breaker and Estrada ready to get in.
And this is what they need. Can Pee-wee get to Estrada? Both Team America dazed. I don't think they saw that move coming. I know I didn't.
Here
and here we go.
Estrada.
Estrada finally the legal man in the match. And he's got some energy to spare. Just hard shots to both men here from Team America.
Oh, that might be short leg. No.
Hard elbow. Going airborne off the second rope.
Oh, Sonny just cuts him off right there.
Estrada now thrown into the turnbuckle. And this doesn't bode well for the young Quebecer.
Oh!
And oh, Roselli going crotch first into the turnbuckle. That can't feel too well. You can see the look on his face there. But Larry Hunter just on top of things.
Marcus,
however, Estrada going, stepping on the back of Hunter, knocking him down right into a backbreaker. Oh, baby, what a move by Estrada on Roselli. And Estrada has the momentum going for the pin. One, two.
Larry able to break that up. My God, what a foot stomp. Rolling into the backbreaker.
That is a move that Marco calls the double stunt backcracker.
Pee-wee got him, just tagged himself in. I don't know how right that is.
A Death Valley driver. This could be big business. Sonny Roselli going to the top rope. Will he be able to hit it? And no! Marco knocking Hunter into the top rope. And a dropkick knocking Roselli all the way from the top down to the ground. Dangerous Donnie, there for his teammate now. What are we going to see now? Double Enziguri! Oh, baby!
Knocked in next week with that double Enziguri.
I don't think he knows where he's at right now. And what are we going to see now? Both men going airborne.
Oh, man.
This could be the perfect frog splash and a leg drop. And it is.
Oh,
it's over. There's no way he can kick out. And the titles are coming to IHW. Oh, baby, can you believe it? Marco Estrada and Pee-wee have done it. celebrate. Marco and Peely have done it. Taking to the crowd, Marco and Peely are the champions. I can't believe it. The titles are in IHW, the North Atlantic Wrestling Association Tag Team titles, and the AWA World Tag Team Champions, Marco Estrada and Pee-wee.
Hold on, hold on, hold on.
Hey.
Tequila champion! Wait a minute. I didn't spend all that money bringing these belts up to see the wrong team win. There's clearly, you guys pinned the wrong guy.
What do you mean they pinned the wrong guy? That was a fair and square three count. Restart the match. And now Team America quickly jumping on Marco Estrada and Pee-wee, who are still in celebration mode. These guys are still celebrating their victory with the titles. What does he mean they pinned the wrong guy? Chase, did you see the wrong guy? I didn't see the wrong guy.
I don't know. I was trying to keep track of what was going on. I got called over there by Brad McDonald from Local Moncton.
Oh, no. That's the Death Valley Driver. Here comes the big splash. Oh. Big business. Oh, my. Oh, baby. Whoa.
Oh, no.
And just like that. America wins the titles! Team America is the new North Atlantic Wrestling Association Tag Team Champions and AWA World Tag Team Champions. Oh no! The titles were in IHW! Pee-wee and Estrada are the champions! But no, Team America wins the titles back!
No, if we had replayability, I'd go back and look at the tape to see which one actually was legal.
What a disappointment.
I'm pretty sure it was, Sonny. You know, Brad McDonald is the guy who put this together, got the money, got the belts here. In the end, I guess it is his decision. Sonny and Larry, Team America, new AWA World Tag Team Champions.
What a disappointment for Marco and Pee-wee. What a hard-fought match by these two guys. They're not tag team guys. They're up against two bigger wrestlers, and they win the titles. In my opinion, they're the champions. Brad McDonald strips them of the titles, restarts the match, and now the fans giving it to Brad McDonald. Folks, we still have a great card coming up for you here at Mayhem 08, the title match, the IHW Heavyweight Championship, Mr. Suave, Joshua Arrow, and the number one contender, Titus, BT Bobby Mann and Sidewinder Street Fight, and of course, we have Ken Banks and Julian Young in a 2-3 falls match.
The following contest is scheduled for the best 2-3 falls. Introducing first from Nottingham, New Hampshire, weighing in at 242 pounds, Ken Banks!
Hey, 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 hey
okay.
Yeah, that's better than a great athlete such as yourself.
What a great show it's been so far here at Mayhem 08, and it's not about to end yet. Chase, we could see two, we could see three matches in one coming up here next. Julian Young versus Kenneth Banks, best 2 out of 3 falls. We will finally find out who the better man between these two is.
No doubt about it. This is the proverbial rubber match, as you want to call it. Kenneth Banks scoring the first win some time ago, and last month Julian Young getting the second victory.
Each man with one apiece, and of course this all started because Julian was fine admitting defeat to Kenneth Banks, went to shake his hand, and Banks would have nothing to do with it.
Right, Kenneth Banks showing a little bit of disrespect towards Julian Young. Julian Young, a very honorable wrestler, you know, knows when he's been beaten, but not afraid to say, hey, we had a great match, let's shake hands.
As we are set to get things underway between these two gentlemen, Chase, both these guys, very experienced wrestlers, so it should be a very technically sound match, or matches, I guess.
Exactly, both of them are very technically sound, but it's hard to say which one's going to win this match. As my old partner Malcolm Mann used to say, you're a fool if you bet on wrestling, so don't bet on this match. If you want to bet on anything, though, bet that it's going to be a phenomenal, technically sound match.
And I think the fans here at the rec center know what they're in for as they're clapping to get these guys underway. Yet to see any sort of offense by either man yet as they're just circling each other. But here we go as they decide to tie up now. Julian Young, Kenneth Banks, best 2 out of 3 falls. Tie up in the middle of the ring to get things going.
Nice takedown there by Julian Young.
I was going to say, just like that, they're both already on the mat.
Yeah. As many people probably know or don't know about Julian Young, he's a 9-year amateur pro. Basically, it's when he was old enough to wear a singlet, he was wrestling. In high school, he was had a lot of victories on his high school team. But then, you know, if he wanted to be an amateur wrestler, I'm sure he could have had a really successful career. But no, he just loves pro wrestling so much, he wanted to get trained, he wanted to entertain these fans.
And he does that. But not to discount Banks. Banks is a 9-year pro. He's kind of like an American version of Julian Young.
Right. People don't want to admit, but Kenneth Banks and Julian Young are more alike than people think. Kenneth's just a little bit more cockier than Julian Young.
And we're seeing a very technical match here to get things underway so far. Neither man mounting any sort of offense. A couple takedowns here and there. But they're both, it's like they know what's coming and they're just able to counter it like that.
Well, they've wrestled each other quite a few times right now. Like I said, this is pretty much the proverbial rubber match. They fought each other before in tag battles. But they both, like I said, both got one victory, just trying to one-up each other.
And here we go, a headlock by Julian Young. Take down with a quick pin, 2 count.
Yeah, very few covers in the early goings. I think Julian would rather have a tap out submission as opposed to a pinfall.
Another quick roll up, 1 count by the referee. Banks just putting his hand in the face of Julian Young as he's trying to break the hold. Spinning over is Young with another quick pin, another 1 count by the referee. Strange to see so many pins here so early, as they're only getting 1 count.
Well, exactly. They're really fresh at this point. They're just going for pins right away. I actually spoke with Julian Young earlier today. Said he's been hitting the gym very hard, harder than he usually hits, just upping his cardio because he knows that this match is going to go at least 25-30 minutes.
I didn't know anybody could hit the gym harder than Julian Young. He is always at the gym. And these guys were both at the rink or at the rec center here very early today, and you could just see them sitting in their separate corners, not interacting with anybody, and just focusing on this match.
Exactly. We like to reiterate a point that Julian is a tape trader, tape watcher. He's always getting DVDs of matches and things like that. He's just basically, he's what I like to call a student of the game. He likes to measure his opponents, looks for ways to counter moves that no one's probably never thought about. But that's a very dangerous tool when you're going up against someone like Julian Young.
And I think we're going to see some of those, as you mentioned, innovative moves, fixing in with the name of Innovative Hybrid Wrestling. That's what it's all about, is one-upping your man, and you've got to be able to counter what he's going to throw at you. And so far, all we've seen is Kenneth Banks and Julian Young countering what the other one is throwing at them.
No, no, about it. And you hit the head right on the nail there. It's the name of this company is Innovative Ibet Wrestling. People come from all over, Quebec, Maine, Nova Scotia, to prove themselves in this ring. You know, it doesn't matter if there's 50 people in the crowd or as we have tonight around, I'd say, 300 people. They're just looking to have the best match possible.
And it's been a doozy of a match so far, as not really much slams or punches, but a lot of holds, as you see Julian Young with another hold on Kenneth Banks in the middle of the ring right now, and a lot of countering, which is exactly what these two are known for. And there you see another counter by Young, just quickly reversing the wrist lock, going for a quick pin now, getting a two count this time, but able to kick out as he's still pretty fresh as Kenneth Banks.
Exactly. These guys are more ground and submission specialists as opposed to any other type of like aerial high flying as you would expect from like someone like a Marco Estrada or a Pee Wee. But that doesn't mean that they don't have the tools to get it done. We look at Julian Young, former IHW champion and a former AWA North Atlantic tag champion. So he's got the tools to be a champion. He's been out of the title hunt for a little bit, but expect big things for coming Julian Young. And look for Banks there, trying to go for his finisher.
Finally some offense, and he looks like he's trying to get the 5-point buster, as you mentioned, but Banks is going to have none of that as he just grabs onto the ropes. Speaking of Marco Estrada and Pee Wee, I still can't believe they got stripped of those titles. Man, that would have been huge for this company.
Exactly, and I tried to speak to Brad McDonald earlier, and he just basically said he was following the match. He didn't know why no one else was following it, and he keeps saying Larry was not the legal man in the ring. But, you know, It's his money, he brought in the belt, so it's his decision if he wanted to restart the match, I guess.
Sticking with this match now, Kenneth Banks now in control as he has an arm lock there on Julian Young. Julian Young, I'm sure, focusing right now, thinking on the mat, how am I going to get out of this? And here you see he's getting back to his feet. But Banks rather not letting go, and now Young with the reversal, and Young in control.
Exactly. I think whoever gets this pivotal first pinfall has got a definite advantage. Well, not only the fact that, you know, it's 2 out of 3 falls in the first fall, you're ahead, but also it gets into the mindset of the other guy. It's like, I just got beaten. If I don't step up my game and get another pinfall, I'm going to lose the whole match.
As you mentioned, it is best 2 out of 3, so these fans getting treated to a couple of matches at least here between these two technically sound wrestlers. Julian Young still in control with that arm lock. He's had that right arm of Kenneth Banks tied up for, I'd say, a good solid minute now.
The point of the fact, too, this is the first time it's the best 2 out of 3 falls in IHW. First time anyone has ever mentioned the fact that they wanted to do best 2 out of 3 falls. I think Kenny just ripped the face of Julian Young to drive him back down to the mat. And
now Julian using his flexibility to kick Kenneth Banks in the head.
Here's our shot.
You see Banks stunned there, and there's a takedown by Young, and again grabbing that left arm. He's been working that left arm quite a bit. Here's a quick pinfall. 2 count by the referee. That left arm has got to be starting to numb a little bit for Kenneth Banks.
And Julian Young's got him in that crossface submission he likes to use. Oh, wait.
But here's a roll up by Banks. Kick out by Young. Young just slapping the back of Banks now, as he was able to kick out, and still with that left arm.
Yeah, and Julian's locking that in. He's got it right in the center of the ring. Not great ring positioning there for Banks, but, oh, he's going for it. Whoa!
Kenneth Banks gets the first pinfall.
The winner of the first fall, Kenneth Banks!
Jeez, can you believe it? Where did that come from?
That just came out of nowhere. I was just mentioning the fact that he's in the center of the ring, can't get to the ring ropes. Yo, he would pretty much had to tap out, but nice counter there to get the pinfall over Julian Young. So Julian Young is down. He's got to win the next 2 falls to win this matchup.
And he's in trouble now. As you mentioned, he's the underdog. Banks, one up on Young. And you can see with the cockiness of Banks there as he goes and talks to the fans, taking a breather for himself. And why not? He just got the first pinfall.
And he just does too. He threw a water bottle into Julian Young. I'm guessing Banks wants him as fresh as possible for this next fall. But he better get back in the ring there, because one of the decisions is count out. The ref hasn't started the count yet.
I think Julian Young's still a little bit in disbelief having a chat with the referee. I'm sure he didn't see that coming, as he had that left arm of Banks for a solid 2 minutes, and then all of a sudden Banks able to roll over Julian Young and get the quick pinfall.
He's got a little smile on his face. He's like, yeah, you got me, but just what? I'm going to come back here, so I hit these chops.
Hard chops there by Julian Young. Banks going to grab the rope now and sets him up for another hard chop there by Young. And another one now. Ripping the skin of the chest of Kenneth Banks with those hard chops. Now Banks grabbing the top rope, sending Young over. Young able to land on his feet with his cat-like reflexes. Going to the top rope with the missile dropkick. What a dropkick by Julian Young. Going for the pinfall. Two count there. As Banks rolling out of the ring, he's going to take a breather after that hard missile dropkick off the top rope from Julian Young.
Smart move by Banks, actually rolling out of the ring, taking a breather. Julian just came back with a slew of offense there. Chops and that springboard missile dropkick. Oh,
now another dropkick there as he slams himself into the mat to hit Kenneth Banks on the outside. And what's he going for now? Looks like he's going to go for a...
springing off.
Oh, baby! Kenneth Banks able to counter that with a hard shot to Julian Young. And Young is down. And that cannot bode well for Julian Young, already down one pinfall.
The ref's imploring these guys to take it back in the ring. I don't think the ref is even going to try to count these guys out. He just wants a clean pinfall or submission finish to this matchup.
Banks in control now after that hard shot of the springboard vaulting press there by Julian Young. And Young not able to recuperate from that yet. Just holding onto the mat for support as he walks around the ring. And Banks just following him, stalking him like prey and hitting him around. And you see the face of Julian Young. He is not feeling too well right now.
No, I wouldn't feel too good either after getting my face slammed into the ring apron like that as Kenny rolls him back into the ring.
Julian Young in the corner now, taking more hard shots from Banks, and Banks with his cocky attitude. A shot, taunting.
Kenneth Banks asking Julian how he likes that, because I wouldn't like it if I was getting hit like that. Oh.
There you see Kenny using his veteran, presence to avoid that, but...
Yeah.
And what's this?
Nice neck.
Kenneth Banks.
Nice neck breaker there, using the rope to his advantage. He hung Julian Young there on the second rope and just planted him with that spinning neck breaker.
Nice modified neck breaker there by Banks. And you see Julian just sitting there holding his neck as it was slammed into the mat there by Banks. And all Banks has to do is go for a pinfall here, and he'd be victorious. Two pinfalls in a row. Instead, that could be his downfall. He walks around the ring taunting the fans, giving Julian some time to recover from that move.
Nice move there by Banks there, scraping his boots across the face of Julian Young. Added a little insult to injury there, but you know, he really has got to take his focus off the crowd and off the referee. Just keep going for those quick pin covers. I think, like I said, he's a little bit cocky. He thinks that just because he's got the first pinfall, he's in full control. But Julian can come back and get another fall.
Both these guys, both very experienced. A nice nightbreaker there by Julian Young, going for the pinfall, and now...
Well, floats over, and he's got him in an armbar submission.
And you can hear writhing in pain Kenny Banks. Nice move there by Julian Young. Banks able to get his feet on the ropes now. Referee forcing Julian Young to break the hold. Banks back to his feet with a kick to the gut. Now a super kick to the face of Julian Young, and Julian Young looks like he might be out on his feet.
That armbar took a little bit out of Kenneth Banks. I think he's going to take some time here to recover from it before he tries to finish off Julian Young.
You can see Young just laying there. Now a pinfall by Banks. But that extra time he took to recuperate allowed Young to recover, and he was able to kick out there after the kick to the gut and the super kick to the face.
It's going to take a lot more than that to take down Julian Young as Kenneth Banks went for another cover. You know, Kenny got in a lucky pin. You know, I don't want to discredit anything to that counter, but it was just pure luck that he was able to get that counter and that pin. It's going to take a lot more to knock down Julian Young. Julian Young, a very dedicated athlete.
Hard elbow drop there by Kenneth Banks, knocking Young once again to the mat. That being said, Julian Young has to be in desperation mode now. He's been slammed around for the past couple of minutes, and he has to win the next two decisions to defeat Kenny Banks.
Kenny Banks in for another cover, and you're right. He's got to wait for Kenny to make some other type of mistake so that he can gain the advantage and get a pinfall, make this an even match.
Banks still in control, slamming the head of Julian Young there into the turnbuckle. Now some hard shots, more chops. Another hard shot there by Banks.
We're a good distance away from the ring, but we can hear those forearm shots from here. I was going to say, like, hopefully it picks up on the camera, because if you're not here to experience this live, I really feel sorry for you.
and looked at the presence of Julian Young, gonna go for that springboard back elbow drop, saw that Banks was able to counter, and instead with a reverse slam, and oh, Tilt-A-Whirl DDT! Oh baby, where did that come from? After taking a shot off the second rope from Julian Young, Banks able to counter the offense of Julian Young into a tornado DDT, and once again, Julian Young is in trouble and looks like he's out.
Yeah, no question. Julian Young got up on the second rope there. I think he paused for a second, trying to make Kenny think that, yeah, I'm going to spring him off and I'm going to kick him in the face. And oh, come on, a total disrespect.
That is just disrespectful. Kenny Banks taking a break to have a sip of water and then spits it out on the face of Julian Young.
It looks like Kenny wants to finish this off with a submission. He's got a standing crossface there, trying to make Julian tap out. Julian is right in the middle of the ring, though.
I think it's going to take a little more than that. Don't discredit Julian Young here. And he's also got the fans behind him. The fans here do not like Kenneth Banks.
No, exactly. And Kenneth Banks actually debuted here last Mayhem. Took some time off, though, to wrestle more in the States. Came back around the end of 2007, and then we started this little feud here with Julian as he gets that quick cover.
Nice roll up there by Julian Young, you're right, able to count his Kenneth Banks, and what a clothesline by Banks. He was able to survive that quick pinfall and just hammers Julian Young down to the mat with a hard clothesline. But Julian Young able to kick out once again, using more energy as he's forced to kick out by Banks. And Banks has been in total control of this match so far, the second match.
Yeah, the second fall of this match, he's been definitely controlled. There have been opportune times where Julian is able to mount some type of offense, but Kenneth Banks is able to cut him off. But, as you mentioned before, Kenneth Banks definitely does not have the support of the fans, whereas Julian Young has been in IHW since our inception, since day one. Been at every show, pretty much in multiple main events, multiple matches at times, and pure technician. I said, I won't be surprised if we see two-time IHW champion in Julian Young sometime in the future.
And there you see the fans giving their support to Julian Young as he grabbed the momentum, but just slammed with a Russian.
I brought Russian leg sleep there by Kenneth Banks, and he gets right back into the headlock.
And again, Banks in control of this match. As you mentioned, Julian Young had the momentum for a split second, had the fans behind him, stood up, but got nailed by that Russian leg sweep of Kenneth Banks. And Banks just able to keep control and keeps the headlock onto Julian Young after the leg sweep.
At this point, I think Kenneth Banks is just trying to wear down Julian Young. Julian Young's got a lot of energy. Like I said, he's been hitting the gym so hard to up his cardio, to up his energy. And at this point, I think just cinching in that headlock is going to take away whatever energy's left in Julian Young.
Boy,
this match already been going for 17 minutes so far. That's the two falls, that is. The first one, a quick fall for Kenneth Banks. He was able to counter a submission hold by Julian Young and get a quick pinfall. The second one, taking a little bit longer. Banks been in control the whole time. But Julian Young now with the support of the fans, once again getting back to his feet. And this time, oh, what a backbreaker by Julian Young. Just slamming the spinal cord of Kenneth Banks right onto his knee.
Crowd really getting into this match, and there's potentially one more fall left and Julian can get a pinfall or a submission here.
Nice neck breaker there by Julian Young after a couple hard clotheslines, and Young all of a sudden in control going for a pinfall and two count as Banks able to get that right shoulder off the mat.
Good move there by Julian Young. He went for a couple of punches, looked like he was going to go for a third, and just stopped him right there and said, no way, I'm just going to hit you from behind.
And now a Tilt-A-Whirl backbreaker by Julian Young. That could be it. Going for the pin. And just at the last second, Kenneth Banks able to get that shoulder off the mat and kick out after a nice Tilt-A-Whirl backbreaker by Julian Young.
Julian.
So we see another counter here by Young. Rolling up Banks. Banks able to get out of that, however. Julian Young once again.
Oh, we got a series of counters here. Each man trying to get a pinfall.
Numerous pinfalls here, all two counts. Both men, neither man wanting to die, rather.
Julian Young trying to go for a backslide there, but no.
Counters into a Northern Lights suplex. Oh, baby! That could be it. But able to counter out is Kenneth Banks. And what's Julian Young doing here?
Well, if Julian knows that if they're going to kick out of the Northern Lights, he'll just...
And another! No, able to counter out of it. That looked like a tornado DDT. Catching the super kick now is Kenneth Banks. Looks like he could be going for a submission hold here. Able to counter
it's
once again, Julian Young, and he rolls him up.
Oh.
And Julian Young out of nowhere, able to roll up Kenneth Banks after the missed super kick.
The winner of the second fall, Julian Young. This is the third and final fall of the match.
Still two. Your song Athletic, weighing in at 215 pounds, BT Bobby Fan.
I don't even think the pussy's going to come out.
And Chase, we are underway here in the street fight between BT Bobby Mann and Sidewinder. This one is going to be bloody. This one is going to be brutal. It's going to be a hellacious match. BT Bobby Mann, known for street fighting.
No doubt about it. And Sidewinder actually tried to one up there on BT. He was waiting for him at the aisleway. But BT, I think, saw him in one of the crack of the curtains there. Just took his time and then just cracked him over the head with that trash can.
What a match are we in store for here? Oh, everything is legal. You can't get disqualified. You can use a chair, a table, whatever weapons you can find underneath the ring, in the crowd, anywhere in the building is legal here in this match. And this doesn't bode too well for Sidewinder, who wants to get into modeling or whatever else he wants to get into other than wrestling.
Yeah, I tried to have a few words with Sidewinder there before the event, and he was too busy on the... Oh!
What a shot by BT Bobby Mann there on Sidewinder.
Too busy on the phone with his agent or manager or whatnot, trying to get him all these acting deals. But I tell you, if BT lands a few more of those punches, his agent is not going to be calling him back.
No, I think you're right. That was a hellacious punch there by BT Bobby Mann. Street fight rules in effect here for this match.
Like you mentioned before, you cannot be disqualified. You cannot be counted out. The only way to win is by pinfall or submission. Sidewinder grabs a chair from underneath the ring.
Not able to hit BT Bobby Mann, however, is BT able to get out of the way. Now BT has the chair. But Sidewinder jumping into the arms of the referee, not wanting anything to do with that, but just being dropped. If I was a referee, I wouldn't want to be hit by a chair either.
And I wouldn't want to be catching Sidewinder either. Sidewinder, very inexperienced in street fights. He's basically never had any. He's never had a street fight before.
He hasn't had many fights, period. He's the youngest megastar on the roster.
Exactly. He's only 19 years of age, and he's been wrestling since IHW's inception. But like I said, he's very inexperienced when it comes to street fights. BT is pretty much the king of the street fights.
Here you see BT still with that chair, trying to get the fans behind him.
I think Sidewinder bit off a little bit more than he can chew here tonight. And he's taking a little bit of time outside the ring.
Perhaps Sidewinder smarter than we thought last month when he decided to allow himself to get counted out instead of facing BT Bobby Mann in a street fight.
Yeah, but if you remember the stipulation, BT wanted it was an open challenge street fight. Sidewinder just had a regular match. But he said if BT beat him.
Oh, baby, what a shot! A punch to the chair, to the skull of Sidewinder.
If I were a Sidewinder last month, I actually would have tried to win the match. Because, like he said, if BT won the match, he would have the street fight here at Mayhem. What's BT going to do here?
Looks like he's going to try to slam Sidewinder out of the chair. Unable to do so, however. Now Sidewinder perhaps going to try something. And instead slammed face first onto that chair. Oh my, that did not look good. And then a boot to add insult to injury.
I hope Sidewinder doesn't have any upcoming gigs because I don't think he's going to get paid.
And there you see Sidewinder not able to get himself out of the chair. Perhaps doesn't even know where he's at right now.
Yeah, he went full force into that chair. He slammed head first and he just kept sliding. He got sucking. Oh,
and maybe
he's got a kendo stick.
Kendo stick. And the back of Sidewinder is wide open. Oh! What a shot from that kendo stick to the spine of Sidewinder. Oh, another one!
I think he's begging to the ref to get him out of the chair. Oh, no. Oh, no!
Oh! Oh, baby! Spanked by kendo! And Sidewinder fighting with the chair around his neck now, slamming it into the gut of Bobby Mann. How Sidewinder's even able to stand up after all that is beyond me.
You can see the welts on his back starting to form. I'm surprised he didn't crack him open enough to start bleeding.
Although I'm sure we haven't seen the last of either of those weapons here in this match. Sidewinder checking his buttocks now to see how they're faring.
I don't even want to ask why he'd be worried what his buttocks looks like.
Now Sidewinder with the Kendo stick, adding insult to injury with the grotesque motion that I don't even want to picture Sidewinder doing. And another shot to the back of BT. Both these men taking some hellacious Kendo shots here in the early going.
Man, this is a side of Sidewinder I've never seen.
Oh no! BT just writhing in pain after those hard shots.
He's choking him on the bottom rope, or sorry, second rope.
But that's illegal in this match.
Nothing the referee can do. He can implore him to please try and not do that, please. But I don't think Sidewinder gives a crap.
No, both these men going through great lengths here, and now you see a little bit of a cross face neck lock by Sidewinder with the help of the top rope, and now the Kendo stick just choking BT Bobby Mann.
BT gasping for air. He's not giving up. He's not giving up.
Now the referee finally gets Sidewinder to release that choke hold with the Kendo stick. What else will we see here tonight at Mayhem? What a show it's been so far, and it continues here with this street fight. Sidewinder against BT Bobby Mann. Now Sidewinder with the chair again.
And with all the punishment Sidewinder's been dishing out, he hasn't even gone for a pin cover yet. I don't know what he's got planned here.
Looks like perhaps a backdrop on the chair. BT the bigger man. Sidewinder not able to get him off his feet. Some hard elbows there by BT. Now Sidewinder able to do it. Oh, body drop on the chair. That could do it. Here we see the first pinfall from Sidewinder. BT able to kick out after two. Sidewinder frustrated, going for another quick pin. Another two count. Now some hard shots by Sidewinder.
Sidewinder's got to keep BT down on the ground. And he's got to stay away from those fast punches, because BT is all hard hitting. He's a first degree black belt in Kushinkai karate.
Sidewinder with a hard kick to the back there. Now he's going to get the chair again. Having a chat with the fans, you could see that the fan asked him why he threw the chair out of the ring. He said, because I changed, and why he was going back to get it. He said, because I changed my mind. And that's just the attitude of this 19-year-old kid, who's fairly successful here in IHW, but it's going to be interesting to see how successful he's going to be here tonight. What a kick by Sidewinder. You can hear that all the way here at our broadcast booth, and we're behind four or five rows of fans. See how successful he's going to be here tonight in this first ever street fight for Sidewinder.
Sidewinder better turn around.
BT
stop banging on the crowd.
And went to go kick BT, not knowing BT had the chair. Oh, baby! Super kick into the chair! Sidewinder, this could be it! BT just able to kick out. Wow!
That was all impact on that. I think there's a little bit of a desperation move. Sidewinder was trying to punt BT in the head. BT blocked it with the chair and then just went for that vicious super kick.
And Sidewinder able to nail it.
Oh,
and now just slamming the head of BT into that chair. Now you see posing for a picture. There's that model-esque / metrosexual / whatever else you want to call him attitude of Sidewinder.
Sidewinder's a little bit of a showman. If there's any opportunity that he can show himself off, he's going to do it.
Looking for the stinger splash and hits it. Throwing his entire body weight into BT in the corner on the turnbuckle. Now a hard Irish whip into the corner.
He's going to try it again here, but...
And what's he going for now? Looks like he's going to set up the chair there, maybe to lunge himself off of?
Perhaps he's going all the way over to the other end.
Some high risk here. There it is. Right into the turnbuckle. BT able to get out of the way. And now countering with some just vicious shots. And that's what BT's known
for. Oh! Look out!
Bulldog onto the chair! Bulldog onto the chair!
With the amount of shots that BT and Sidewinder have taken, I'm surprised neither one of them have been busted open yet.
But look at the welts on the back of Sidewinder from that Kendo stick.
I imagine there's probably some on the back of BT as well with that IHW t-shirt on that he wears with pride every match he's in.
Going with that chair again. What else are we going to see in this match? This has just been non-stop brawling, brutal action here in the street fight.
I'd like to say BT's always trying to one-up himself here in street fights. He's looking for the BT cutter there.
Unable to get it, trying to get the BT cutter on the chair, and now Sidewinder looks like he's going to go for the angel wings on the chair now. BT able to counter that. Once again, perhaps going for the BT cutter. Will he get it this time? No, again.
No.
But it's Ecstasyde! Ecstasyde onto the chair!
Sidewinder into
this
the
is it! No, BT, how was he able to get his shoulder off there? He just took an Ecstasyde headfirst into the chair. That's just pure instinct. And street fight, I don't even know what to say. I'm at a loss for words how he was able to get his shoulder off the mat. Sidewinder just honking a loogie out of the ring there. He just does not care. That's he does what he wants, where he wants, whenever he wants. Looking to go for the angel wings again here. Again, BT able to counter. Now will we see the BT cutter? Looks like he's got it set up for him this time. There it is! BT cutter onto the chair! Oh, baby, this is it! It's over, folks!
That's good, finish it.
And Sidewinder able to kick out. He just took a BT cutter face first onto the chair. Both these men... there's no way they can know where they are right now.
Sidewinder definitely showing his toughness there, kicking out of the BT cutter, being slammed into a chair as well. Like we said, inexperienced in street fights. But Sidewinder pulling up all the stops in this matchup here tonight at Mayhem.
You see BT holding his back as he rolls his way outside the ring, grabbing a drink of water while he's at it. But what's he going for now? BT reaching out of the ring. You hear a cheer from the fans. Is it what I think it is?
It's a table.
It is. BT going for a table. And what are we going to see with this?
I don't know if this would be too wise of BT to introduce a table. Last time he introduced a table, he got Spanish flied into it by Titus.
And boy, what a move that was. I had goosebumps for a week from that. As now BT looking to put Sidewinder through a table, and this does not bode well for the kid. What are we going to see here?
BT's got it set up in the corner there. I think it's his purpose to drive Sidewinder full force into that table set up in the corner.
And here we go. Will we see Sidewinder? And is he going to suplex him into it? But Sidewinder, with great awareness, they're able to turn around and counter it.
Oh,
now Sidewinder trying. Now BT able to counter. Hard suplex there by BT. That table still looming in the corner.
You can use that any time. Whichever man gets up is going to have the advantage to use it.
BT first to his feet. Now he's going to look to set up the legs. Could we see a BT cutter perhaps put Sidewinder through a table? Who knows?
If we do, that's going to spell lights out for this match.
Could spell lights out for a lot of things for the kid. His modeling career, perhaps his wrestling career. And here we go. Table set up now.
Sidewinder slow to his feet. BT just kicks him back down.
BT is just a brutal son of a gun. He is pure force.
Exactly, like we said, he's hard hitting. He's got the first degree black belt in Chusin Chai Karate. So not as very technically sound as some other people on the IHW roster. But when he gets in the ring, he's all business.
No razz, no pizzazz, none of that stuff. He's not in it for the glory. He's just in it to hurt people. And now we see him.
Sidewinder setting up gingerly on that table.
And what is BT looking for here? And this could be it. The signature elbow drop onto Sidewinder through the table. Will we see it? BT going to the top rope, going for some high risk. Sidewinder looks like he's starting to come about, however. And look at this, playing possum perhaps, has BT now on the second rope.
There was a lot of time to rest there for Sidewinder. He may have gotten a second win here.
Now
looks like he's gonna try and back suplex him into it.
But BT able to knock him down. Sidewinder continuing with the hard shots. Now some headbutts to the solar plexus of BT Bobby Man. As Sidewinder looks to get the upper hand here. Now he's going to the top rope. Going to the top rope. Could we see some high risk?
Oh, no.
Look at this.
Up.
Oh my God! Powerbomb through the table. And now BT with the chair.
BT's not done yet.
This
he's
going to
drop it with that chair.
He's going to the top rope. Oh, my God. Sidewinder just got powerbombed through a table. And now look what comes next. Oh, baby. Elbow drop on the chair. This is going to do it. What a match! What a match! Sidewinder, powerbomb through a table, then he gets that elbow drop with a chair from BT. And Sidewinder yet to move.
I can imagine the phone call Sidewinder's making to his agent right now.
We can't make the Marlin gig tomorrow. I gotta pick splinters out of my back.
Still to come, folks, we have, of course, the title match. Mr. Suave, Joshua Arrow, taking on the number one contender, Titus. And, of course, the newcomer, Marcus Hall, taking on the IHW veteran, Zero. All that still to come here at Mayhem OA.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall. Introducing first from Fort Bridge, Connecticut, weighing in at 236 pounds, Marcus Hall!
Chase, it's time for Marcus Hall to make his IHW debut here against Zero, a veteran of IHW. He's in tough here.
Yeah, exactly. Marcus Hall, making his debut here. He's really getting tested by Zero tonight and actually being tested by the fans. You see no reaction as he came out.
They didn't know who he was.
Exactly.
I didn't know who he was until 20 minutes before the show.
We don't know a whole lot about Marcus Hall. I tried to get a word with him earlier to find out a little bit more of his background. Just kind of kept to himself there. I think he was just more focused on debuting here in IHW as opposed to making small talk with anyone.
and focused he was. I tried to talk with him as well and just sort of looked at me like, who the hell are you? And kind of went on his way. So Marcus Hull, not known for talking, I guess, but we'll see if he's known for fighting as he takes on Zero here. And nice acrobatics there by Zero. Able to do a flip there to avoid the arm lock, and now he's got Marcus Hull in an arm lock of his own. Hull able to reverse, however, in a headlock. Here the fans calling for a move that I don't think you're going to find in any wrestling encyclopedias anywhere.
No, you're not going to find that anywhere. Now, Zero, like we said, been here pretty much since the beginning. You know, he's very seasoned. He's been getting a whole lot of wins here and there, trying to get up the ladder, possibly get a title shot.
See some nice arm toss there by Zero, and then a missile drop kick. And then a quick pin, two count there by the referee. Zero's got some momentum going for him now.
Oh, Marcus just shoots him off there, and Zero just passes off the arm.
Oh, baby, what a spine buster, Marcus Hull. Just powering Zero and slamming him into the mat. Marcus Hull is no small customer. He's a big boy.
Exactly. As I announced, he's around the 240, 250 mark there. Zero around the 180 mark.
So big size advantage here for the newcomer, Marcus Hull, making his IHW debut.
And if there was anyone that we were going to put him in against, it was going to be Zero. He's the most seasoned, one of the most seasoned members of the IHW roster. Not just for wrestling here in IHW, but he's been on the most major maritime tours, working for other organizations.
You see Marcus Hull there with a big elbow and then a flex for the fans. Now a stomp to the face of Zero. Hull now again taunting the fans. Not perhaps a bit of a mistake there by the newcomer, however his power able to capitalize from him.
Yeah.
But Hull seems to, when he gets the advantage and has Zero down, as we see a quick pin here by Zero, too, able to kick out his Marcus Hull. But when we see Zero down, Hull goes for a taunt over continuing to do whatever he's doing with Zero. We see a nice hard clothesline there as he's able to overpower Zero once again. But you'll notice, like, maybe not doing it right now, as now he's doing a good job of staying on top of Zero, but the last couple times, he would get his offense, he would mount his offense, and then, like right now, he's taunting instead of continuing to hit or do whatever he's going to do with Zero.
Yeah, no question. And like I said, we don't really know much about Marcus Hull, you know, his experience, how many years he's been a professional wrestler, or if this is just his first outing or whatnot. But looking at his size and the way he moves in the ring, doesn't look to be that way.
Oh, what a boot by Marcus Hull. The big man going airborne. Two count again. Zero very resilient.
And of course, it's going to take a lot to knock Zero down and try to get a W off him.
Hull once again going over and talking to the crowd, and that could end up to be his downfall against a veteran like Zero. Now you see Zero able to capitalize, and a big knee to the face of Hull. And now a neck breaker by Zero, and Zero flips as he does the neck breaker, rolling over into a pin. It looked like Zero landed on his head there.
Yeah, and of course, I think what Zero's going for, trying to get a little bit more extra torque in that neck breaker, but to no avail.
The Thunder Kiss! Hull just hit the Thunder Kiss, and that could be it. One of his signature moves. And now going for a stomp off the rope. Why didn't he go for a pin after that? Perhaps Hull showing some IHW rookie attributes here, as he hit one of his signature moves, the Thunder Kiss, and didn't capitalize on it at all. Now setting him up for, it looks like, a camel clutch.
He's just wrenching in like a full Nelson submission move. I think he's trying to make Zero tap out here. Zero's trying to... now he sits it in.
And you can see the face of Zero starting to turn red.
Yeah, definitely, he's cutting off the flow of oxygen there. Zero's definitely got to get out of this hold if he wants to send out any type of offense and get the win over Marcus Hull.
Neither one of these guys really have the fans behind them. You could see Zero looking for some motivation there and wasn't finding it. And Hull just hammers him back down to the mat with a hard right hand.
Well, that's the rule of thumb here in wrestling. You know, you cheer for who you like, you boo for who you hate. You know, and some of them faces the wrestler, some of it doesn't even bother them. Tyrell really doesn't bother if people cheer him or boo him. He's going to go in there and get the job done as he hits that spinning heel kick on Marcus Hall.
Able to get out of the powerbomb there that Marcus Hall was looking for. Now a couple spinning kicks by Zero.
Zero has fast feet. He's known for his kicks. Goes in for a cover, but only gets two.
Close call there for Marcus Hall, looking for his first win in his first match as an IHW megastar.
Pretty much, if he gets a win here, this will put a sparkle in the eyes of the promoters here. Maybe bring Marcus Hall back to IHW. What's he setting up for here?
It looked like it was going to be an Oklahoma Slam. However, he couldn't keep Zero in the hold. Now Zero looking for... Oh, baby, what a power bomb! And this could be the Griever. Two power bombs. If he turns it into a DVD, a DDT rather. And here it comes, back-to-back power bombs to Zero. There's the Death Valley Driver, the Griever, Marcus Hall. What a move, or three moves. Two power bombs and a Death Valley Driver. Now the pinfall by Marcus Hall, and able to kick out a Zero at two. Just pure wrestling instinct now by Zero as he's able to get that shoulder off the mat, yeah, following the Griever and the Thunder Kiss. He's taken both Marcus Hall's signature moves so far, and he's been able to kick out of both.
Yeah, Marcus Hall can't believe it. He's actually able to kick out of two power bombs and a Death Valley Driver.
Now you hear the fans getting behind Zero as he's taken the brunt of the punishment so far in this match.
Zero up and over the ropes there. Ooh.
Hard right hand to the face of Hall, and Hall keeps coming back for more. Another hard right hand. Zero going to the top rope. High risk maneuver. And the Zero Buster. He hit it off the top rope. Pinfall. And that'll do it. Zero Buster.
Here's your winner, Zero.
What a move by Zero. Going airborne, hitting that Zero Buster. Knocking Marcus Hall out, and he's able to get the pinfall. Not really much offense there for Zero, but he's able to get it done when it counts.
Nice knowing you, Marcus Hall. Maybe we'll see you again, maybe not.
Great outing by Marcus Hall, whether we see that man again or not. That was a great first match, mounting a lot of the offense. Perhaps we'll see him again in IHW. But folks, there's only one match left here on the Mayhem 08 card, and it's for the IHW Heavyweight Championship. Mr. Suave, Joshua Arrow, taking on the number one contender, Titus. We're here tonight at the Kiwanis Center for the 8-man number one contender championship tournament. And this one is over. Will the new Titus Arrow begin? March to Mayhem is on as the main event is set.
Do you really think I would show up to your little show?
Project Kill IHW is in effect. The fans get smaller and smaller.
We want Titus! We want Titus! We want Titus!
I am goddamn disgusted! Happens to him and ends your wrestling career before you take me. But if it doesn't, I will make sure that I do.
Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to the official contract signing for Mayhem. Now, there is a specific clause and it involves you, Titus. When this is signed, if you touch Suave before Mayhem, you will lose your IHW Championship match.
So, right here you see, you cannot touch me until Mayhem. So what I'm doing right now is give you my pen so you can sign too. Wait a second, go fed.
Give me a stinking pen, you son of a.
And on May 25th, history is gonna go down in the making. Because if you walk out victorious that night, you will be the longest reigning IHW champion there ever was. But when I walk out of that match victorious, I will be the only man to hold that title twice. So Mr. Suave, on May 25th, you better show up ready, cause I'm gonna walk out victorious and it will be the beginning of a new Titus era.
I will tell you what I'm going to do to prove to your little marks over there that Suave does not fear Titus. I will come in this ring right now and face you one-on-one. But I forgot to mention, like it was stated earlier, if you put one finger on me, boy, you're going to lose the title, your title shot, and you will never, ever face me again.
Get ready for a whole lot more!
Joshua Arrow!
And Chase, either way, history is going to be made tonight. Titus, either the two-time IHW champion for the first time ever in IHW, or Mr. Suave becomes the longest reigning champion ever in IHW.
Titus, former IHW champion. He currently has the longest reign of IHW champion, winning it at our very first show in that spectacular ladder match that you can find at ihwrestling.ca in its entirety. If he wins tonight, he'll be the first two-time IHW champion. Let me say, Mr. Suave wins tonight, he will beat that streak and become the longest reigning IHW champion.
And what a ladder match that was, and I have a feeling, Chase, that this is going to be just as thrilling of a match here tonight as one of these men look to make history. Suave taking a little bit of a walk here to the outside, having a chat with some fans, exchanging some pleasantries, I'm sure.
Yeah, Titus wants to take this back into the ring, and Suave's just taking a breather. Taking a walk around the ring.
If the match stays outside the ring, it's not going to do anything for Titus. He's got to pin or make Suave submit to get that title.
Smart move there by Titus there, missing down that elbow. And again, Suave rolls out of the ring. We want to throw a couple more accolades towards Titus. He's also a former AWA North Atlantic Tag Champion, and also probably one of the most prestigious honors he has. He is the winner of the third Maritime Cup in a one-night tournament to determine who is really the best in the Maritime pro wrestling scene.
And this match has been working its way, as you mentioned, all those accolades for Titus, leading him up to this second title shot. We can't forget what happened last month when, of course, Titus had to sign that contract where he couldn't hit Suave before this match here at Mayhem. But then Suave was able to bust Titus open with that belt, and Titus has just been itching to get at Suave ever since.
No doubt about it, I was there at the contract signing before April Rain, and just to see the hatred, Titus wanted to claw Suave in the worst way. But now the bell is rung, the stipulation is over.
Oh, baby!
Titus just clocks him!
What a shot! He's been waiting for that for 30 days. What a shot by, you could hear that. You could probably hear that back in Quebec City, Quebec.
Look out, Titus gonna fly!
Oh, an airborne! Oh, baby! What a move by Titus, going for the over-the-top plancha and smoked it! Oh my God!
He also took out a security guard there. There's a security guard walking around with Suave. There's a lot of IHW fans here that do not like Suave. And the security guard's here to ensure their safety. Man, Suave back up to his feet already.
And these two men are just, oh baby, what a shot. These men just exchanging shots now. What a match so far. These two men are just beating the hell out of each other.
All right, now they're taking it into the crowd. Look out! Oh man, I hope that if IHW women fans are using the bathroom right now.
Titus and Suave are going to the ladies' room. You can see all the fans gathering outside.
We can't see inside. Our cameraman Malcolm Mann is in there, I believe, or he's outside. I can't get a good angle from here, but.
And here they come back outside. Titus.
Suave's got the toilet paper around him.
I wonder if Titus gave him a swirly while they were in there.
Oh, if he did, that would be so sweet.
Is these two men looking to make their way back into the ring now? Fans in IHW are half on their feet, half still in their seats here. as they now finally do get back into the ring. And what a shot there by Suave. And he's got rolls of toilet paper to throw at Titus. Something I never thought I'd see in a professional wrestling match is a toilet paper move. Titus and Suave went into the ladies' room and came back out and are still beating the hell out of each other.
Yeah. Mr. Suave, Joshua Errol, a very cunning professional wrestler here, enlisted the services of Team America to win that IHW championship back at September Surrender.
Suave with the upper hand right now, just throwing some hard shots at Titus, but Titus able to come back and just a huge uppercut. I'd say that was half uppercut, half haymaker, just nailing Joshua Errol in the face as Titus wants to become the first ever two-time IHW champion. And now
nobody home for that smash there in the second rope, but Suave able to move out of it.
And a dragon screw into the second rope by Suave, just wrenching the knee of Titus, and Titus is in pain. This does not bode well for Titus.
I don't like it, but that's why they call it innovative hybrid wrestling.
Joshua Arrow now mounting some offense, or Mr. Suave, as he likes to be known as. Well, current IHW champion, sorry, Mr. Chase.
I like to point out the fact, too, that this is the first one-on-one meeting ever between Mr. Suave, Joshua Arrow, and Titus. They have never faced each other one-on-one.
Of course, Titus wasn't allowed to lay his hands on Mr. Suave over the past month after signing that contract before April Rain. Finally getting his hands on Mr. Suave. However, Mr. Suave right now with the upper hand.
I think that was the point of Mr. Suave, to put that clause in that contract. He wants to play my games with Titus. He wants to get him off his game before this match as he just brings Titus's leg across the ring post.
And that cannot feel good for the left knee of Titus as it just... it almost wrapped around. If his legs were elastic, they'd be tied in a knot right now around that post. The knee is not supposed to bend like that. And you can hear the fans just getting on the back of Mr. Suave and starting to perhaps get under the skin of the current champion.
Nothing really faces Joshua Arrow. These fans can boo him all they want. He's still gonna go in there and take care of business.
We've already seen some very innovative things here in the early going of this match. Of course, the top rope plancha there by Titus. Now Mr. Suave mounting the offense. What else are we going to see here to decide who the IHW champion is going to be?
I don't know, but Suave's got him in a single leg crab there, working on that knee that he injured earlier on the ring post.
And you can hear Titus just groaning and moaning in the middle of the ring. He's got nowhere to go right now, and Mr. Suave knows that what he's doing right now is a good thing.
Titus crawling towards the bottom rope. He's got to get there. He's got to break the hold.
But Mr. Suave, Joshua Arrow, able to pull Titus right back into the middle of the ring. Not allow Titus to grab that rope and force the referee to break the hold.
He manages to finally get there.
And now Suave breaks the hold.
I'm surprised that he doesn't try to get himself intentionally disqualified. There's no stipulation in the contract for that. If Suave gets himself disqualified, he can just leave with the IHW Championship.
And Mr. Suave is... oh, baby, what a kick to the back of the leg of Titus. You could hear that smack throughout the rec center here in Riverview.
Mr. Suave very methodical, working on that knee of Titus, trying to keep the big man down. Titus is a powerhouse. Uses big impact moves like the Deuce Driver, like the Spanish Fly, to take out his opponents. And now Suave ascending the top rope, probably going to drive himself onto the knee from the top rope, but Titus able to
stop. Counter there.
Yeah.
And now what's Titus going up for? Looking for a running big boot, and smokes Joshua Arrow right off the top of the turnbuckle all the way down to the concrete floor here at the Coverdale Rec Center.
And no pretty blue mats here. That's all concrete, baby.
Joshua Arrow falling at least 6, 7, 8 feet there from the top rope all the way down to the concrete floor.
Refs diminishing a 10 count. They got to get back in the ring.
Titus now throwing Suave into the ring post. Suave's head just bounced off that metal, and he's now down.
This is the first official IHW Championship match since September. You heard the plea from Mr. Suave, Joshua Arrow, back in September. Actually, last Mayhem, he vowed that if he won the IHW Championship, he would never, repeat, never defend it in the Maritimes. He's been defending it all over Quebec in the promotions there in R2W and PWA, but he has said never will he defend it in IHW.
However, there was a contract stipulation declaring that if he did not defend it in a certain amount of time, he'd be stripped of the title. And now faces Titus right now for that title. First time, as you said, since September's surrender when Mr. Suave Joshua Arrow originally won the title.
And Mr. Suave and Titus are on our stage here.
And this doesn't bode well for either man.
Watch out for those drums there. Those are from Iron Giant. They played at the opening of the show here. Don't want to wreck those.
And look, oh, like no. Titus is going for the deuce driver on the stage.
Not on the stage.
And
my God!
Baby! Deuce driver on the stage!
Ref being very lenient here.
Can you believe that? Deuce driver on the stage!
But Titus has got to pull him back into the ring. It's got to be pinfall submission in the ring.
Referee over there making sure Mr. Suave is able to continue.
You think he'd be coherent after that?
It looks like Titus just dragging him because Mr. Suave can't even hold his own weight. And he is just dragging him.
Just dragging him by the foot there. All the way back to the ring.
Mr. Suave might be out cold. If Titus can get him in the ring quick enough, he might be able to pin him here and retain his championship, become the first two-time IHW champion. Mr. Suave finally back in the ring now.
And still up to laying, a count of seven.
Still lying motionless after that deuce driver on the stage.
There's the cover. New champion. No.
And somehow, some way, Joshua Arrow able to kick out of a deuce driver on the stage. Unbelievable. We've seen just about of everything here tonight. Just a little bit of everything here tonight at Mayhem, haven't we?
Yes, we have, and this is the... Oh, looks like Titus is going to go for the deuce driver again.
If he hits, no, he's not. He's putting him on the top rope, and Chase, could this be what we think?
Spanish fly. They hear the fans asking for it.
They're asking for it. Is Titus going to give it to them? He's setting up for it. Here it comes.
He's got the arm hooked. Oh! Swap over the counter and just ring Titus up on the top rope.
The cojones of Titus are going to be the same color as his pants after that. As he's now dead duck sitting on the second rope. And now a dragon screw off the top rope! Oh baby! Suave going for the pin! And somehow Titus now able to kick out.
Suave's been really good at working on that left knee.
Multiple dragon screws now to Titus. One off the second rope, one off the top rope.
Let's not forget he's smashing his knee earlier on the post.
Multiple wraps around the ring post and now just stomping it is Suave. Suave couldn't believe that Titus was able to kick out there.
Titus can't even stand up on that knee. He's just dropped now. Look at the smile on Suave's face.
That's a devilish, that's an evil smirk. But still holding his head after that deuce driver. What side effects? And a big boot by Titus! Oh man! Out of nowhere, Titus! With a big boot to the back of the head of Suave.
That's gotta hurt him more than it hurt Suave because he had to use his left knee to deliver that kick.
But after a deuce driver on the stage and now a big kick to the back of the head, what has Suave got left? His brains are gonna be mushy.
Rest of ministering the 10 count.
Both men down
six.
What an unbelievable match here for the IHW Championship. The main event of Mayhem 08. Both men back to their feet now. Just trading shots in the center of the ring.
Nice forearm shot there by Titus and Dalton. Joshua Arrow just returns with a right hand. This has just turned into a slugfest now. Titus getting the upper hand now, driving those elbows and getting Suave into the turnbuckle.
Hard Irish rip there by Titus. And a hard elbow as Suave saw that coming all the way.
Yep. Running knee lift.
What a move by Titus, as you mentioned, the running knee lift. Titus going airborne on Suave.
And that had to hurt him a little bit because, again, that was the left knee of Titus. Oh, ducks under, look out.
Big boot. Titus with the running big boot. That could be be it.
Best big foot in the business. This could do it.
And a two count is Suave just able to get that shoulder off the mat. Titus looking to capitalize now on multiple headshots to Mr. Suave, the last one being that humongous big boot. Suave, however, able to capitalize with the backsplash there. But Titus
hooking the legs there.
Titus wraps his leg. And what's this? A rear naked choke. Titus is using a submission move. I've never seen this before from Titus. Not known for his submission moves. I don't think he's ever done one before.
I've never seen a submission move out of Titus either. This is a new one out of his book, a rear naked choke.
And what a repertoire for this wrestler now. Titus is a powerhouse. We've seen him go airborne, and now he's got a submission hold. That rear naked choke came out of nowhere.
Just want to be able to roll out of it and get to the ropes. And that forces the break. Like I said, Titus is a very versatile wrestler. He can pretty much do it all. He's a powerhouse. He's a big man. He can take to the air with that plancha. Not many smaller guys can do that. Titus is able to do it with the greatest of ease.
You see the fans here getting behind Titus now as he's back to his feet first. Both men feeling the effects of this match. And Titus
maybe going for
like
another deuce driver. No, Suave's wiggling out of
counter.
It.
And now Suave with a spine buster. Suave with a huge spine buster to Titus.
Of course, he likes to claim he invented the spine buster. He calls it the Suave buster. You know, he's out of all the people I've seen, Suave seems to be the most full of himself. He's the IW champion, but like, he's just so full of himself.
Titus now looking to go to the top rope again here with Mr. Suave. And Suave grabs him by the throat and throws him down. And now Suave looking to go airborne.
Titus. Suave not known for his aerial expertise. And
oh baby, what a DDT! Suave going airborne!
Rolls into the cover, this could do it!
And two, only Titus able to kick out. What a DDT by Suave. I don't think I've ever seen that from him before.
Especially leaping off the second rope. Like you said, Suave not known to take the air. He's pulling all the stops tonight to retain that ISW championship.
Both these men doing everything they can. You hear the fans getting behind Titus now. Mr. Suave with the upper hand after that huge DDT leaping off the second rope.
You see the look on Suave's face. Looks like this let's go Titus chance getting to him. Oh, look out. Go for Deuce Driver. No, countered.
Countered by Titus and now going to pin Suave. No. Instead, he's going to pick him up. Looking for that power bomb. No, now he's reversing it into another Deuce Driver. And he hits it. Oh, man. That's the second Deuce Driver that Mr. Suave has taken. And this could be it. We could have our first ever two-time IHW champion. Can Titus get the cover?
He's got the armbar, but there's two.
And Mr. Suave able to kick out. Oh my God, how was he able to kick out there?
Pure guts, pure instinct. I don't think Suave knows where he's at right now after taking two two-stripers. First one being on the stage.
Both men just giving everything they have here. Pulling out all the stops, as you mentioned before, with new moves from either of them. Titus with the submission move, Suave going airborne. Suave has survived two deuce drivers.
He looks like he's going for a third, but Suave gets out of it.
But Suave is able to counter.
No, he's not going to hit the deuce driver.
Titus set for the deuce driver, and he hits it. Oh my God, he's got the pin, and Titus able to kick out. Suave using Titus's own finisher. And
not
Titus
today,
able to
Suave.
Kick out. Oh my God. This match is so intense.
What the hell is Suave doing? He's ripping off the turnbuckle.
Hits the security guard with it. And now what's he doing?
He used the exposed turnbuckle to help beat Ryan Storm for the ISW Championship. Speaking of the championship, Suave has it in hand. And the ref's distracted.
The ref is busy picking up the turnbuckle. Now he's got his back turned as he tries to put it back on. But Suave has the belt.
I just picked off the skull of Titus. No, he can't win it this way. No.
Not this way, no.
No.
Titus able to kick out. Suave just looks stunned. He just hit Titus with the championship and Titus was able to kick out again.
Swamp thought he could distract the rack by ripping the turnbuckle off the ropes and using the belt to his advantage. Now the ref sees him with the belt. He's not going to let him hit him this time.
And perhaps Titus thinking of getting disqualified there. And now Titus, oh my god, what a huge clothesline, sending Swamp flipping through the air. And now Titus.
Now he's ripping off the other turnbuckle. What is he doing? And Titus going.
What's he got?
He's got handcuffs. Signature for Titus. This is how he wins certain matches, with handcuffs.
And oh! What a shot with the handcuffs.
He just clocked Titus. I'm sorry, he clocked Swamp with those handcuffs.
Swamp might be out cold. Referee turns around. Here's the pin. And now Swamp able to kick out. What will it take to pin one of these two competitors?
Both men using tactics behind the referee's back. Swamp with the belt, Titus with the handcuffs. Neither man will go down for a three count.
And what will it take? We've seen multiple deuce drivers, multiple weapons shots. And
Swamp now Swamp is using the ropes.
But the referee able to catch that. Swamp, known for his illegal ways, trying to use the ropes there to help him keep leverage and pin Titus. But the referee on his heels, able to catch that. Titus slow getting to his feet now, so Mr. Suave gonna help him out.
I was gonna send him with the exposed steel. Oh!
And Suave,
Suave into the exposed steel.
And now Titus, that left knee that Mr. Suave has been working on all match, going first into the exposed turnbuckle. And now look at this, Mr. Suave going airborne again, potentially, as he makes his way to the top rope.
Suave slow to recover there. Both men taking extreme punishment. But Suave up to the top rope.
And look at this! Look at this! Hot Spanish fly! There it is! Oh my god! Spanish fly! History has been made in IHW. We have our first ever two-time IHW champion. Titus has done it, and it took multiple deuce drivers and a Spanish fly, but he's done it, and the fans are giving him a standing ovation, Chase.
I didn't think that Titus could go for the Spanish fly, and you saw Boo hit his knee on the exposed turnbuckle. Swamp going to the top rope, trying something high risk. Titus able to run up, deliver the Spanish fly. Titus, the first two-time IHW champion. Congratulations, Titus.
So the new Titus era will begin. On behalf of Johnny Chase, my name is Gerald Kwan. Thanks for joining us.